I should be live now. Can you guys hear me? I hadn't pressed the button of go live yet. This is oh, welcome everyone. Yeah, like I said, this new YouTube studio is a bit confusing because I just wanted to put all the settings in order before I went live, but then suddenly people started joining and I got viewers, but I wasn't live yet. But let me just share this link on my Twitter and on my Discord server. May guest generation be in your favor. Well, I'm gonna need it. Because if you've seen the thumbnail, it's a custom scenario, a snowy one this time, made by one of my members of my Discord server. And it's quite a difficult one. You need more guests, quite a bit more than Amity Airfield, for example. Let's see. This... Alright, that's all done. Now I need to change one more thing. Alright. And now we can start playing. Hey, Peter. And Robin. That's my bro. He's amazing. Welcome to the stream. Let's start up the park, shall we? It's called Frostbite Castle. Good luck, thank you. The goal is to have at least 4,000 guests in your park at the end of October year 4, with a park rating of 600. Well, it's going to be interesting. I have not taken a look at this scenario yet, except for taking the screenshot, but I don't know any rides that are going to be available or anything like that, so I'm very curious. Hello, back to Canada and back to Japan. Well, the park is opened. Let's see, free admission price. Okay, so we charge for the rides. Well, let's open every ride. We apparently start with a bunch. Let's see what we have. Frostbite Logs. It's a junior coaster with quite decent stats for a junior. Ooh, from Brazil, nice. Hello, back to Brazil. Frostbite Logs. Okay, that's a nice junior coaster. And let's see what we have here. Jousting Knights. Which is a steeplechase. With alright stats. It looks nice. I like the diagonal bits. From Morocco. Damn. I have people all over the world. How is it in Morocco? My stepbrother and his girlfriend went to Morocco a couple of months ago. They liked it a lot. Okay, what else do we got? We got a couple of, like, there's a Twister variant. And we got a Top Spin variant, which is a trebuchet ride. We got Dodgems. And a bobsleigh ride. Plague Bearer. Ooh, I like that. Hello from Poland. You know what's a great thing about Poland? The accent. I love it when Polish people speak English. It sounds fantastic. And also with decent stats. This Helix is a bit long, but you know, it's an alright coaster. Hi from Bulgaria. Ooh. Ah, hello from Germany. Germans also have a great accent. I have a couple of German girls in my mentor group at uni, and they have great accents. Oh, we're already getting rain. Well, time for an information kiosk, and you know the deal. Wait, it's already at 20 bucks. Oh, there's already an information kiosk somewhere then. Oh, right here. Let's open it up. At 20 bucks. He knew me. He knew what I do. Ooh, we start with a lot of stalls. More than just these 10. Where are they? Oh, they're here. Are information kiosks really that good? Well, consider this. Say you have 100 guests in your park, and it starts to rain, and half of them buy umbrellas for 20 bucks. That's already 1,000 bucks with only 100 guests. Now imagine if you have 1,000 guests in your park. It can really just give you a lot of money. Minnesota is like its own country to an extent. Well, I mean, the state, yeah, sort of, I suppose. All right, let's build our first ride, a launched freefall. Also, let's try to do this without any advertising. Let's see if I can get 4,000 guests in a year with no advertising. Can you build a launched mini golf? I'm not using cheats in this one. All right, let's see what the scenario options are. Okay, so only harder park rating, so that's not too difficult. Wonderful lighting necessities like umbrellas. I am indeed a capitalist. In, well, only in Roller Coaster Tycoon. Ooh, these prices are already set nice and high. I suspect these are the exact prices that you can charge without it being too much. What are the wind conditions? 4,000 guests at the end of year four. You know, I can just, I think, just add some text here. This is still some old text. How do I edit this? Scenario goal 4,000 guests at the end of year four. There we go. That should make it easier. The optimal length for queue rides. It really depends. Like for roller coasters, you mostly want a fairly bit longer queue line, especially if you get rain. Because. Oh, didn't think of that. Because if you get rain, and your coasters are no longer have any guests in them, you won't make any money with them. That, of course, only goes if you charge for the rides, which we do in this scenario. And for other rides, well, flat rides, you mostly just don't want them to be too long. Doesn't really matter if they're like very short or moderately short, but not too long because that can really make guests unhappy. Launched observation tower. Lol. From the last video. Yeah, I'm not gonna do that here. I really like making that video. If you make the entrance and rides cheaper, well, the entrance is as cheap as can be because it's free. And the rides cheaper, that does not affect the number of guests you get. So, no, that doesn't affect it. All right, let's see if I can do the interlocking thing. Because I like that. Ah, there we go. Ooh, I like this coaster. So, at the beginning of the stream, I will be building like slightly more efficient rides. And once we get the ball rolling and we manage to get like enough guests per month and per year, we can do a little bit more things suggested by you guys and stuff. Because then we have a little more freedom. Alright, I can probably charge up to 10 bucks for this. Maybe a bit more, but 10 is good enough. Also, what we haven't done yet, zooming out. Look at this scenario, it's beautiful. Just wanted to say it's amazing to see RCT content on YouTube and even more to have it as well made as yours is. Thank you. Look at this, it's a nice castle. Oh god. No. Why do the guests have access to that path? That's a terrible idea. Where's the scenery invisible button? And the ground invisible button. No. That's not something we're gonna do. I'm going to relocate all of these guys. Because I don't want them to get lost over there. Five, yeah. Any more guests? Luckily, the creator was not cruel enough to connect all the paths to it. Although I will have to disconnect all these other bits. Oh jeez, there are even more. Do they have another connection there? No. What about the ring around the park? Yeah, I did see some more connections, so I'm going to have to remove them. Which is not very difficult. Just gotta make sure that I don't miss any. Let's see. Here. And here. And here. And that was the last one, I think. That's something I like about Planet Coaster. Guests will not go into areas that don't have any attractions. Sometimes you do kind of want that though. Oh, I need to open this still. Sometimes you do want guests in areas with no attraction. Like if you, I don't know, a long time ago when I used to play RST2 as a kid, I used to just build like lakes with flower beds and, you know, little trees around them, just as like a calming area or whatever. And I like seeing my guests walking there. Let's do some benches. We can do some more rides later. There's one more by the coffee shop. Where's the coffee shop? I let them run wild. I don't really focus down my staff. Also, someone asked me if I ever played Roller Coaster Tycoon 2 high, like a couple of minutes ago in the comments. No. I've never done any drugs, so no. Would probably be an interesting experience, though. Do it with a webcam. I don't have a webcam. Well, the laptop I am using to read the comments does have a webcam. But that's kind of, you know, I'm recording this on my computer, not my laptop. So it's kind of really difficult to make that work. So I'm not even gonna try. I do want to buy a webcam at some point, though. Let's make it a bit faster. Are the guests any rich? 70 bucks, that's alright. What's the hardest scenario I've ever played? It's a little scenario called Quantum's Edge. And it had a guest requirement of 3,400 guests. And you were never allowed to make your park rating go below 700. And you had very little land. Everything you bought was like 90 euros per piece of land. It was very expensive. And basically everything was difficult. You had to build rides longer than 600 meters because of no ads in combination with what's it called? Harder gas generation. It took me about 7 years to complete it. And I failed twice. I had to reload an older save. So why am I not doing this on Twitch? Well, someone said it correctly. Yeah, 6IX. It's because I got big on YouTube. I don't stream often. I stream about once every month, once every 2 months, about that. And if I do it on Twitch, then I'm not gonna get big on Twitch. I have to get people over from YouTube to Twitch. Then it's easier to just stream on YouTube. Why not Dumpert? Because Dumpert is the most retarded site of the Netherlands. So please no. I mean, yeah, I could like post a video on YouTube saying I'm live on Twitch, and that would probably work to an extent. But I'm already on YouTube. And YouTube allows for live streaming. So I don't see why I wouldn't use YouTube. Send the barrel roll the other way. Wait, the barrel's fine. Oh, the first barrel roll. I'll fix that in a minute. You know, I personally never got into the whole Twitch culture thing with the custom emotes and that kind of stuff. I really don't get it. So maybe that's also part of the reason why I don't stream on Twitch. The whole Twitch culture. Alright, this should be an interesting enough ride. 15 bucks. Let's color it icy. That's better. Make this bright red. Oh, I like that. Chris Sawyer. Would be quite amazing if Chris Sawyer was watching my stream. Do I have any mechanics? No, I don't. I only have two entertainers. Well, they're fired. I have taken a couple of breaks in my life. I think between 2013 and 2016 I didn't play a lot. And between like probably like 2008 and 2011 I didn't really play. Can you show the stats of your coasters? Yes. You should be able to read them easily now. They're actually quite low. Expected them to be higher. But 6.67 is alright, I suppose. For a coaster, well, it's not that long. And also this coaster. Also, let's give it a color. This is 6.13, 6.16, and 2.82. What's up, Endercroft? I don't see what advantage Twitch offers over YouTube. Yeah, I agree. Like, well, it probably has a bunch of advantages, but for someone like me, it probably doesn't. So, yeah, that's why I'm doing YouTube, not Twitch. A chat that works. I mean, the YouTube chat works fine. I'm not doing streaming for the money anyway. If you want to make money with streaming, you gotta be a full-time streamer, like stream at least multiple times a week. And that's not for me. I'm not a streamer. I like doing a stream every now and then, but that's about it. Ooh, let's build one of these. Let's build this design. This is the smallest design that gets no stat penalties and you can charge 20 bucks for it. It's insane. Yeah, basically, Chris asked, that's what I meant with the Twitch culture. It's obviously not entirely accurate. There are a bunch of streamers that are not like that, that get subs and stuff. But still, yeah. I mean, I do have a Patreon. It's also partly because people are asking for it. But yeah, I do like making money with this because it allows me to not get an actual job and just do this for you guys. But I don't really like doing streaming specifically for the money. It's nice to make money with it, but if you do streaming specifically for the money, it becomes a bigger part of your life. You know what I mean? I don't really want that. And then streaming gets more stressful as well. I forgot you existed and I'm sorry for not watching your most recent videos. I mean, don't worry about it. If you don't watch my videos, that's fine. You don't need to. What are you studying? I'm studying AI. Which is a nice study. Learning some interesting things. Do I still have the long hair and the beard? Yes, I do. And my beard keeps getting fuller, which is nice. Can you make an AI that learns how to play Rollercoaster Tycoon? People haven't even built AIs that can build actual good rollercoasters, let alone play the entire game. So, nope. They have built AIs that can build functioning roller coasters, like ones that actually do a loop with a proper chain lift and end up back at the station, which is already quite incredible, but they're not any good. Sounds pretty metal to me. Well, it so happens to be that metal is my favorite music genre, so that's where it comes from. How much strategy is behind this scenario? I don't know yet. If I just used marketing, it wouldn't be a lot of strategy because marketing is overpowered, but I'm not using marketing. So that's going to be interesting. Also, I am quite ahead of schedule. Because to get enough guests without marketing, or just get enough guests, I need to get 1,000 per year. I'm already past 500, and I'm not even past half a year. Name a non-cliché metal band. Nightwish. They're my favorite band. And they're about to release another album in a couple of months. And a single is going to be out in 6 days from now, which I'm really excited for. What's the scenario? It's a custom one. Which singer of Nightwish do you prefer? Floor Jansen. I actually saw her live a couple of days ago, the 24th in Groningen, which was amazing. She had a couple of Nightwish songs, songs from the program The Beste Zangers, which she was on, from her other previous band. She did a couple of songs. It was a great concert. Will there ever be a new roller coaster? Oh boy, do I have something to say about that? So I don't know if any of you have seen the new trailer that came out 2 days ago for Rollercoaster Tycoon Story. It's a mobile game that you start off with a park and it's broken and you need to fix it, which is kind of the story. And then you need to like solve puzzles, Candy Crush style in between. Do not download it. It's fucking shit. Don't get it. It only gets downloads because of the name Rollercoaster Tycoon. So, no. I left a comment on the trailer, which is basically just saying, fuck off and stop doing this. But yeah, just no. Will there ever be a remastered version of Rollercoaster Tycoon 2 or anything like that? Maybe. If Atari stops being greedy and actually starts caring about their community, then maybe, yeah. I hope so, at least. Let's build a Mine Train coaster. I like those. Let's see. Someone asked me something about Nightwish, I think. Oh, you didn't like Tarja, or just prefer Floor. I did like Tarja. But I think Floor is better. Floor is more versatile. Tarja is purely opera, which is great. And she does a couple of songs better than Floor ever could. But I think Floor is better overall for the image of Nightwish. What are the scenario goals? Look at the top of the screen. Yeah, the problem is if this Mine Train cone hurts the terrain, it's just going to be flat. So that's not going to happen. Do I use OBS to stream? Yes, I do. EA, worst gaming company ever. Why suddenly EA? I mean, it's Atari that's screwing up the Rollercoaster Tycoon name and brand, not EA. I mean, I'm not going to say EA is great, because it obviously isn't. Yeah, good question. What's wrong with Nintendo? Greetings from Hong Kong. Greetings back. I hope you're doing well with, you know, all the stuff in Hong Kong. Okay, how am I gonna get back to the station? I need to... Well, let's first add a photo section. Yeah, RCT3 is quite a good game. It's not up to RCT2, but it's still good. What OS am I using? Windows 10. I'm a Windows fanboy. No shame in that. RCT3 just takes hours to load. Fun fact, I've managed to make a save that actually takes more than an hour to load in Rollercoaster Tycoon 3. And my computer isn't slow or anything, it usually loads normal saves pretty quickly. But I had built a roller coaster about 200 kilometers tall and it took forever to load. Sadly, it now crashes whenever I try to complete it to build back down. So I can't complete it, which is a shame. You're impressed that OpenRCT2 even works on Windows 10. Well, Rollercoaster Tycoon, that's what I'm impressed by. Open Rollercoaster Tycoon is specifically designed to work on modern systems. No, not 200 kilometers long, 200 kilometers tall. Which is also 200 kilometers long, but specifically tall. Greetings from Norway. Ooh, my favorite country in the world. Greetings back. Or maybe my favorite after the Netherlands, I don't know. I really like Norway anyway. What scenario is this? It's a custom one called Frostbite Castle, I think. Yeah, Frostbite Castle. Brazil. I don't know much about Brazil. I mean, I like the rainforest. You're the second guy from Brazil. Unless you're the same guy as before. I don't know that. Norwegian doesn't have stroopwafels. That's a good point. Although it's been a while since I've had a stroopwafel. Do you archive your streams on YouTube? Yes, I do. I should make a playlist with them. But they're all just... They're going to be uploaded to YouTube later. After this, automatically. So you're going to be able to watch it back. Alright, I think I'm fairly comfortable with like the rate I'm getting guests at. Let's pay back this loan, because it's quite a high interest rate of 38%. Let's build a couple of flatterites. I need more of those. Oh, thank you very much, Max Arceus, again. I'm pretty sure that... Oh, this doesn't work. I'm pretty sure that you've donated the most out of anyone to my live streams, which I'm very grateful for. Thank you. Let me also try to fit in this motion simulator. Where did this scenario come from? And till what time am I streaming? Well, until I've completed it, and maybe a bit after that. We'll see what happens. Where did it come from? Someone on my Discord server made it. Let me check who it was, actually. Oh, whoops. Posted in the wrong channel on my Discord server. Oh, well. It was Fred104. My Discord server is linked in the description. So you can join it there. And he's made a couple of other scenarios. Haven't really played any of them, but this is the first one, and so far it's pretty good. Greetings from the Philippines. Ooh, another account from the Philippines. You're the first one this stream, but I've had a couple of people before. I've even talked on Discord with one guy from the Philippines who played Rollercoaster Tycoon. It was a nice guy. Let's do another motion simulator. I like my motion simulators. It's weird being Dutch, born in America, and wild at marshmallows in Groningen, where my father's family is born. I have no idea what this is like. Well, have you ever been to the Netherlands? Like, on a family trip or something? How much do you price your toilets at? I keep them free. I don't like to charge people for things they need and that are essential. Have you ever tried your hand at making pretty parks? Yes, I have. It's not for me. Is the food free then? Ah. But is food essential? I love you guys. I love those reactions. I was joking. I don't price my toilets because I can't be bothered to. And also because it's not... it doesn't really make a difference. Because say you charge your dollars at 10 cents and you get 10,000 guests in a couple of years that go to the toilets, which is a lot, it's only $1,000. Thank you so much, Riley, for the $25. Candy style music on every coaster or we riot. I'll put candy style on them, but not for the entire stream. Because it will get annoying at some point. Thank you so much. I wanted to zoom out with every coaster candy style. Alright, let's see. Candy, candy, candy. There we go. Doesn't really work when you zoom out. Which is a shame. I'm actually not as bothered by it as I expected I would be. So, yeah. I might be able to... Let me see. Ride music, it's already at the loudest. I could make it a lot louder, but that's not going to be nice. And then you also can't hear my voice anymore. Maybe I forgot. Get your pizza! This is horrible. This is absolutely horrible. It's fun for about 20 seconds. What about another roller coaster? That's a very good idea. I'll keep the candy style for a bit longer. Can I show something off once I get the screenshot? I mean, you can post links to a picture here, I suppose. Or post it on Discord, I don't know. Alright, which do you want? An inverted coaster or a compact inverted coaster? Ooh, thank you, Battle Cow, for the $2. Euros, whatever. Here's a hamburger. Thank you. I like hamburgers. So, invert, compact, invert. Surprisingly many people are going for the compact invert. Alright, I'll go for the compact invert. I thought that was an easy run for the invert, but nope. Why do you guys like the compact invert so much? Because I don't like it. Well, it's not that I don't like it. I don't like it as much as the invert. Vekoma SCL recreation. I mean, then there's a pre-build for that. I can do... Something that's a bit similar, though. I can do like a similar start. Planet Hell. Ooh, yeah. Planet Hell is a great song. Although, I must say, I actually like the version with Annette, the live version at Sur Studios, better than the version with Tarja. That's also because Marco's vocals are incredibly on point there. My favorite Nightwish song, that's Ghost Love Score. Okay, so I was like, this is how an invert goes, right? Like the curve drop and then the whatever this element's called. A butterfly? I'm not gonna do an exact SLC recreation because you just have this. The El Condor. That's your exact SLC recreation. Which is boring. I'll do something that's a little bit close. There you have your double inline twist. Alright, now the question is, will it make this looping? Let's do the ghost test thing. At least 6 inversions. Alright. How many do we got? 5. Well, that's easy then. Let's first see if it makes this. Because I don't think so. Nope. That's not a problem though. Because I can just go lower. I don't do this often. Often when I get blocked because I can't make it or anything, I just do something else. I don't often alter the ground. Should do it more often though. Although it's kind of expensive. And then another invert. That's not an invert, that's a twist. That goal does not sound difficult. 4,000 guests in 4 years is quite a lot. It's probably more difficult than you think. I don't think I'm gonna fail it, but that's partly just because I've got a lot of experience. Yeah, without advertising. Basically extreme height, but without money. With money. Yeah, and also a bit easier terrain. But yeah, pretty much. But I also don't want to play a scenario that's too difficult on stream. Because then it's mostly gonna be me just focused on the scenario the entire time. And I can't focus on the chat as much. And I can't really interact with you guys a lot. And like do what you guys want, you know. Which is not as fun for a stream. It's fun when you're playing alone. Where did you put this scenario? I didn't make it. But it is in expert. I'd actually like to see a brutal scenario. There is one. And I've played it. I might be the only person that has ever completed it. It's called Quantum's Edge. And it's very brutal. Also, let's save this. Frostbite Castle stream. Just for the backups. Do you sometimes make custom scenarios? Not ones like these, which are, you know, actually pretty and balanced. I do make custom scenarios, you know, to test stuff or to make extremely difficult ones sometimes, but otherwise not really. Alright, let's give this thing a color. How about... There's a nice combination. I like... And it doesn't really work. It works well on the B&M invert. How are you doing? I'm doing well, thank you. Do you like pay to enter parks or do you only like free entry parks? I like both. both have advantages and disadvantages. And I must say I actually prefer paid for entry parks. Because they're much easier to micro. Have you ever done a scenario where you have to buy all the land and it costs 200 a block? I've done similar ones where you start with not necessarily one block, but like, I don't know, 20 tiles or whatever. And you also have to buy very expensive. Actually, that brutal one, that brutal scenario I was talking about, Quantum's Edge, you start with not a lot of ground, like the amount of ground inside one of these path loops, and you have to buy it for 90 a piece, which is not 200, but it's a lot. Yeah, you kind of get a rough time with the virus stuff, which is annoying. Paper right is better, I disagree. For a couple of reasons. First off, it's not better right at the start of the scenario. If you start out with nothing, and you just plop down a couple of right, you will make a lot more money with pay for entry. Later on, you will make more money with pay for right if you do it well. But that can take a while. And also, it's a lot more micro-intensive. Yeah, we'll make a giga coaster. Well, have fun at work. Or if you will not have fun, at least good luck. Alright, let's get rid of the candy tiles. It was fun while it lasted, but it's a bit too candy-y. If you know what I mean. Couple of rock tiles. This one wasn't playing music. Well, now it is. Let's do fantasy style. Do you consider yourself a coaster enthusiast? Not really. I do like coasters in real life, but I don't go that often. Alright, which ride is still playing candy music? This one, I think. There is still one more. Is it the Steeplechase? Yeah. Wild West style. How do you space out cash machines? I have no clue. I just place one, like, I don't know, once every 30, 40 tiles or whatever. I don't optimize my shop placements very well. I have never actually paid much attention to it. Usually just do this, like, put a couple down every now and then. Thoughts on Planet Coaster? It's a good game, not really for me. It's more for people that actually like making pretty parks. Which isn't me. Also, we're making a lot of money. How much do guests pay for bathrooms? They're free, and I like keeping them free. I don't know why I like keeping my bathrooms free. Charging for them doesn't make you a lot of money anyway, but I don't know, it's just something I like keeping them free. It's the only thing I have free in my parks. Why don't you like Park Attacked? I found it to be quite clunky. To be honest, that's a while ago, so it might be better now. But it just didn't really play as smoothly. And also, I'm really good at Roller Coaster Tycoon 2, and then to get into Park Attack, that would take a long time, and I can't make videos on it like I can on Roller Coaster Tycoon 2, because I just don't know a lot about it. So, let's try to build a path here. I hope I didn't box myself in. I did not. Good. Yeah, that one game that you bought on stream a while ago, that was Factorio. And I've actually played it now. And it's quite good. I completed it twice, launched the rocket twice now. Yeah, I enjoy it. Have you ever played Roller Coaster Tycoon on the original Xbox? Nope. I've never owned an original Xbox, only a 360. Let's add some benches and bins. It's raining, so we're making a lot of money with our umbrellas. Think original Xbox was before its time. Well, if Roller Coaster was on the original Xbox, I got Roller Coaster Tycoon right about when it came out, so that was definitely during my time. I only got an Xbox 360 in 2009. At the time I was 12. And it wasn't too old yet, back then. Will the guests buy umbrellas if it's not raining? Yes. But not if they're expensive. If they're too expensive, they will only buy it when it's raining. Have I ever played Transport Tycoon? Nope. I might in the future, I might not, I don't know. Let's take a look at my research. Ooh, I don't need shops and stalls or scenery and theming or transport rides. Let's see. I want to build some spiral slides. I want rainbow spiral slides. Just like last time. A spiral slide of spiral slides. That would be kind of impressive. Orange. Let's see, number 3 needs to be yellow. Did you ever play Locomotion? I did not. 4 needs to be green, I think. Then blue and then purple. At 9 years old, this game was hard, definitely. I was terrible at this game when I was 9. There we go, rainbow spiral slides. Indigo, yeah, this game doesn't really have indigo. So I'm just kind of putting those last 3 colors together in just blue and indigo, or blue and purple. Which is easier. Have I played No Limits 2? I have not. I don't really intend on to. From what I know, it's mostly just a realistic coaster simulator. Which is not really what I'm after. Making high intensity rides when I was 10 and plating them everywhere. I did not quite do that, but I did often make high intensity rides by accident. So, we have a lot of money. Let's build that Giga Coaster that someone wanted. Oh, I thought we had a Giga Coaster available. Well, let's build a Hyper Twister instead. Closest thing. Oh, we just unlocked it. What the hell? Okay then. We're gonna build a Giga Coaster. That was a spooky coincidence. Alright, let's do the cable lift. I like that. Because it's fast. I'm gonna kind of make a ridiculous one. Boosters! Yeah! This is gonna be fast. Alright, the ghost train doesn't work with cable lifts. That's a shame. This is expensive. How often have you deleted a dynamite blaster in Dynamite Dunes? Sometimes? I don't often play Dynamite Dunes. Have you ever played Kerbal Space Program? Nope. I do have a friend who I think is mod on the subreddit for Kerbal Space Program. He's definitely played it a lot at least. There was one time I was playing on Lightning Peaks, the original game. Someone cheered and had commented your park won the award with the best coasters. Yeah. That's unrelated, but yeah, that can happen. Let's make this a bigger spiral so that we don't end up under in the other track. It's like the Intimidator 305, but the grayout curve has more G-forces. Basically, yeah. It's hella expensive. What do you think of building underground paths? I don't like them because I can't see them. I mean, functionally they're great because they can't be vomited on. But I like to see my path. But that's probably just a personal thing. I don't know. Oh, thank you very much, Ron Eilander. For your €3.49. Any reason why 349? And also thank you, once again, Max Arceus, for the $5. Euros, whatever. What do you think of mod custom flat rides and scenery? What about making it coaster that go through the castle wall several times? The problem is, with the castle wall, is that you can't build through it without cheats and not remove it. I'll show you why in a second. But that doesn't work. Oh, hello guys. Stop spamming, please. So, and what do I think of customs, flat rides and scenery? I don't reuse them really, but I mean, they're fun. Okay, let's hope it doesn't go too fast here. I can always lower it or make it higher. Raise it. Why not sell the path on the wall? Because it looks nice. I want to keep it. Alright, I think this is about enough. We can get back to the station. Alright, let's wait for the cable lift. What do you think of building underground path? I just answered that. Don't forget brakes. I don't need brakes. I've got the station brakes. And if they fail and some guests die, well, it's not my problem. Underground path and bridges. Which do you think is better? I'm gonna say underground path, but I prefer bridges because I can see them. Alright, what speed will you reach? Speed. 194 kilometers. Fuck. No. This entire coaster is completely ruined. Excessive G-forces. Terribly excessive G-forces. Lateral G's then, not vertical G's, but... just look at that. 3.92. Those boosters are a bit excessive. This might... How did I not foresee this? How did I not see this coming? Can't pay full attention. Well, I do think underground paths are useful. I just don't like them. This is terrible. No one's gonna ride this. So let's tone it down. There we go. Let's just put a couple of boosters. You probably don't need... Yeah, those bunny hops aren't the problem. It's the lateral G's that are the problem. You can't really have excessive vertical G's on the Giga Coaster because it gets so little intensity from them. Alright, what do we get now? That's still too much. What about just a single booster? Let's track the train. 162, it's right on the edge. Ooh, and this is over the edge. We're gonna have excessive lateral G's, but that's fine. The ratings will be fine, even with these excessive lateral G's. Because they're not gonna be ultra excessive, so we don't get both penalties. So it will be fine. $20. $3.12. Ooh, shit. That's just too high. That is actually too high. I need to be under 3.10. Let's see. Where can I lower it? Right here. If I make just this one higher. Can you make the Efteling? First off, that would take a shit ton of work. Way longer than would fit in one stream. Secondly, no. I'm not good at that stuff. Remove the last booster. Now I want the booster. I don't think it makes it without the booster. But I think we're fine now. Yeah, 3.08. You see, we have a very high intensity rating of 9.69. But that's still below 10, despite the penalty. So we're still good. It's a speed problem. Nothing was a problem except the excessive lateral G's. Why not play RST3? Because it's an entirely different game. I mean, sure, it's a good game. But that's like saying, yeah, just why not play a different game? That's like saying, why not play this racing? Like, why not play Forza instead of Need for Speed? Both racing games, but it's just a different one. Let's build some benches. RST3 can handle some big parks sometimes. I've built fairly big parks on it. I've actually never had it crash, except the time I built a coaster that was 200 kilometers tall, which isn't something you're really supposed to do in the game anyway. Ooh, guests are flocking to this new coaster. That's great. Let's give it a color. Let's make it yellow and black. Oh, I like that. Let's do the cars. Now let's make the trains one all yellow, the other all black. Hello, Jeff. Let's build a couple of more flat rides. Ooh, the vertical drop coaster. I like that. Do you guys want me to build a vertical drop? A big one? Ooh, thank you, Normal the Band. Start playing RC2 again because of you. Keep up the good work. Well, I'm glad you started playing again. That's amazing. Yeah, I'm first building some flat rides. A vertical maze drop. Maybe extend the station on the gear coast to have a third train. That wouldn't really help, because I think it's limited. No, it's not. It's limited anyway by the cable lift, so another train would not increase the throughput. Do you ever make a custom maze? I've made a couple. But it's not really something I enjoy that much. The first custom maze I ever made was probably only a few years ago. It took me about 15 years to make my first custom maze. Make a giant maze ring hidden inside the wall. Well, how to make your guests get lost 101. Because while it's a fun idea, it's also quite a terrible one if you want to keep your guests alive and sane. Put some merry-go-round music. I can do that. There you go. Yeah, just a hatched in box. I can do that actually. We'll make a fairly small one. We'll make it right here. I want it 4x4. Can you make an underground maze? No, actually, no, you can't. I think at least. What's up, Cobb? Welcome to the stream. Oh, whoops. Ah, damn it. Really doing wallless. Yeah, I made a 3x3 of this one. Guests were absolutely terrible at it. They're not going to walk straight to the exit. I can promise you that. Some might, but a lot of them won't. Also, let's check if our rides are still making money. Some aren't. Because they're too old now. Ragtime music. I can do that. Where is it? I know Rollercoaster Tycoon has ragtime music. There we go. Wait. Why is there rock style? Probably from one of the coasters. That didn't work. But I told you the guests. Why? How stupid are you? You see, that green one was good. He was fast. But like the balloon guy. Come on. It's not that difficult. The exit is right there. Hey, did his balloon just disappear? His balloon disappears when he jumps. Because there are no sprites for that. That's interesting. You just came so close to the exit. No, what are you doing? No. A purple shirt is smart. They're jumping to see where they need to go. Yeah. This is just stupid. I could watch this for ages, to be honest. And I thought the pathfinding on the path was bad. This is even worse. This is way worse. Yeah, they make random actions. Like, they prefer going straight ahead, or they like pick clockwise, and if they can't go one direction, they pick another time until they randomly pick one of the directions that they can go in. It was explained to me a while ago, but I don't really exactly remember it. Also, thank you, guys. Water ride, transport ride, I'll build a water ride. I think I have the log flume. I like a log flume. We're still very much ahead of schedule with the number of guests we need. So that's nice. Wait. Am I just putting... There are now just supports in the maze. Alright. I thought I would have just had, you know, invisible supports. As happens with the game. Did you guys know that the log flume has this element? The reverse turntable. I think quite a few people might not know this. And it will reverse the boat. Are you accepting suggestions today for a funny rides area? Yeah, I'm quite ahead on schedule for completing this goal. So, yeah, sure. I won't use cheats. But I can do funny, silly things. Yeah, if you go too fast, it won't reverse. That's true. Well, it does work right after a drop if it doesn't go too fast. And since that drop is only one tile, it probably won't be going too fast. You forgot to reverse the boat's back. No. Now they will just start reversed after a while. Like, one time they'll start normal, then they'll start reversed, normal, reversed. That works. Also, with your reverser coaster, you can do that as well. Works perfectly fine. Let's see if it works. There you go, works perfectly fine. And I will call this one the Max Arceus ride. To honor my most charitable viewer. Let's build some more stalls. Most beautiful park in the country. Ooh, nice. This scenery is doing something after all. How long have I been playing Roller Coaster Tycoon? Pretty much my entire life, since I was about 4. Which is about 18 years. It's quite a while, actually. More balloon stalls. Ooh, it's getting laggy with all these windows open. Now do a submarine ride. Well, speaking about the most useless rides, the submarine ride, which I do have available actually, is the most useless ride in the entire game in my opinion. I don't think I've ever built a submarine ride in my life. So yeah. Make water, please. I mean, I have the money for it. Speaking about money, let's first place down some ATMs. So that guests will not run out of money. Worse than the boat hire? Well, I mean, it's not worse than the boat hire, but it's so incredibly specific. The water needs to be deep enough. Like, you can only build it underwater. Like, yeah, I just don't like it. But yeah, the boat hire is probably worse. Well, this is the first time I'm building one of these. I'm doing it live on stream. What other games do you like playing? Well, today I've played a lot of Gemcraft. A couple of weeks ago the new game came out. And I like playing Bloons Tower Defense, Battles and Factorio. How can you make go-karts useful and effective? Make it short. That's the only way. Just make it short. They can do like 2 or 3 laps. And money will come to you. It's a great ride. It's one of the best non-coaster rides in the game. Oh, hey, FAD Memes. You're one of the top donators on Patreon. So thank you for that. I do recognize your name. No, I won't, Gijs. I won't name an attraction after you. Not at this point, anyway. Let's do some different color balloons. Let's do some multiple shades of blue / purple. If you want to make it more exciting stats-wise, lay your track on top of each other with spirals on go-karts. Go-karts can't do helixes, only turns and regular hills. Why is my community this positive? I don't know. I like it though. There have been a couple of hateful comments here on the streams Not this stream, but on stream, my streams in general. And then my Discord, but not a lot, yeah. Like, maybe 5 people in total over the past 1.5 years. And I do like it. One Justin Bieber fan dislikes this live stream. Why the hate on Justin Bieber? I don't particularly enjoy his music, but it's not bad. And if I may be a bit controversial, I actually don't... Like, a lot of hate from his was from his song Baby. From 10 years ago. I don't dislike it that much, actually. I think it's an alright song. He was just young, had a high, squeaky voice. Why is the path free? Oh yeah, I didn't really notice that, but that's a bug in Open Roller Coaster Tycoon 2. It will be fixed. Doesn't really matter that much because I have 73k in the bank anyway. Boats aren't reversing with people on it. Oh well. Doesn't really matter. Are the jumping water fountains or snowballs any good? Well, there are positive thoughts associated with them. People can actually think the jumping fountains are nice. And if you go a bit deeper into the code, you will find that the thought that jumping fountains are nice can actually block... Excuse me, can actually block the thought that your park is really nice and tidy, clean and tidy. And those thoughts can actually get you the award for the most tidy park, which will get you more guests. So placing down enough jumping fountains can result in getting fewer guests because you're not getting the thoughts you need for an award you would otherwise be eligible for. The chance is not that big and it's not worth thinking about, but technically it's possible. Also, thank you very much, Achen. Achen D-Locker. Finally, caught one of your live streams live. Unfortunately, I don't have the time to watch it now, but I'm very looking forward to the recording. It's a shame you can't watch, but thank you very much. And have fun watching it back later. Yeah, forcing guests to have positive thoughts sounds like a dystopian novel. Fun fact, how I learned about this, I was doing the video about the awards, how to get all of the awards, and I needed to get the screenshots of all the awards, thus I need to get all of them. And while I was trying the tidiest park one, I had, you know, built a park and everything, and I just didn't get the award. And because guests weren't having the thoughts, and I was confused by that, so I looked at the code and saw that there's a list of four thoughts which are all about the environment, like nice music, nice scenery, nice jumping fountains, and tidy park. And any of those three other thoughts have priority over the tidy park one, and they can't be active at the same time. So if you have a lot of music, which I have now in this park, you can't really get the tidiest park thoughts. So you can't really get that award. What about decorations? Yeah, that's ahead of it as well. Do I have a favorite artist? I'm not really into painting. Well, I mean, I love Bob Ross videos, so Bob Ross, I suppose. But that's, and I do like his, you know, his art, his paintings, but not because I like his paintings, mostly because they look good and, but not because I'm into painting or whatever. They just look pretty. And his videos are great. Is there any reason to make your rides free in a pay-for-entry park? Wait, pay-for-rides park? Yes, very much. If you don't have access to the ATM and you have a guest goal, you might want to make your rides cheaper or maybe even free, because otherwise your guests will be broke pretty quickly and will leave. You can donate money if you want, guys. It's not necessary, of course. You can. I don't know how it works, actually. I just enabled it and people started doing it, but I have no idea how. How actually it works. But like I said, you don't have to. More ATMs. I will build more ATMs. How many do I have? 8. It's not enough. A whole row of ATMs. Yeah, there's a dollar sign on it. I think you need like a PayPal account or a credit card. Yeah, some locks aren't turning, I know. You know, let's actually fix that. Let's do the reverse of turntable here. Will guests just end up emptying their bank account when they have regular access to ATMs? I mean, their bank accounts are infinite because they can withdraw money infinitely long. Can I build a Woody? No. Because I don't have it available. I was gonna build a tall vertical drop coaster before I got distracted. Oh, thank you very much, Pandora. Check in from time to time to keep up with your streams. Love the content and keep it up. I will, definitely. Thank you. For the $5. So let's build this very tall vertical drop coaster. What I love about a vertical drop coaster, it's one of my favorite coaster types. It's just, I don't know, I love the trains, the short, wide trains. But what I love about it is the steep chain lifts. Ooh, these G-forces are gonna be harsh. You'd ride it. You would. This is gonna be like 8 G's. It won't kill you, but it will definitely injure you. But guests will be fine because they're immortal. Unless they get in a crash or touch some water, because then they will either die or drown. Yeah, over 7.5. I think it will be around 7.5. Which, once again, isn't very healthy. Looked like something I've built as a kid back then. Yeah, but you know what's fun about me building these now is I can do these things as a kid, but as a kid, you always end up with crazy high G-forces. But now that I know a lot more about how the game works, I can actually do all this crazy stuff and make sure that I don't get high enough G-forces. Just push the limits, push them a little bit, but just keep them close enough that you're not getting extreme intensity ratings. And I love doing that. Let's give this thing a looping. And another one. And another one. And another one. And I might every now and then still make a coaster that's too intense. But I always am easily able to figure out where the issue is and fix it. This one might be too intense. I don't know. It might very well be. And yeah, I've heard about that euthanasia coaster. And it was not a real, I mean, it's a real concept, but it was not like someone actually suggested to build it. It was just a thought experiment, you know? Oh, thank you, Deppertron. Thank you for the $5. You should try making a pair of dueling coasters. I will. But not here. You know what? I can make dueling coasters go around the castle. Yeah, I'll do that. That's fun. Let's test it. While we're waiting for the chain lift, let me color it. Ooh, no. No. That's better. This one can be bright pink, though. All right, let's see. We'll probably reach around, I think a little over 100 kilometers per hour. Well over 100, 140. Damn. This was not a good idea. This was a terrible idea. I think it's gonna have like 10.5 intensity. Probably a bit too high. Can always remove like two loops or something. Let's see. Just waiting for the stats. Waiting for the stats. Takes a long time. Let's open the ride. 11.36. Well, whoops. First off, let's make this one higher. So that we don't get as much negative G's. Then, let's remove two loopings. Does the game actually have to take this long to calculate the stats? Sometimes, no, but sometimes there's something in the way. It happens sometimes. And something else is like taking up the space which is used for that. I don't know. Oh, hey, mom. Everyone, say hi to my mom. Jacobine Verbaan, say hi to her. Welcome to the stream. That's a nice hill. They like you, Mom. Let's hope the stats are better this time around. The negative G's aren't much better. They're probably gonna still be too high. Yeah. It's not gonna be great. Let's build some path. 10.73. I'll fix that later. Let's first build a path. So I was talking about being able to push the limits, but not too much. This is too much. Let's make this one a bit lower. No, I won't call this coaster, guys. Stop asking for it, please. And we can make this one lower as well. Real vertical drop coasters do have this sometimes, right? They have a bit of a horizontal bit before the drop. This needs to be lower because right now it's not going to make it. It's a negative G issue on the fourth drop. Well, I don't think it's going to be there anymore because the coaster is going to be a lot slower. Because it's not as tall anymore. Still going to be there a bit. But not as badly. Let's hire some more staff. Let's hire some entertainers. Because I want my guests to be happy. 9.82 intensity. I'm happy with that. I'm happy with anything under 10. So that's fine. Actually, yeah, I'm gonna make it more expensive, but not too expensive. Because I don't need any more money, really. I'm not going to name coasters after random people in the chat without any good reason, so stop asking for it. Oh, thank you, Cody. Thank you for the dollar. Appreciate it. Let's lower... Ooh, 3 is a bit too cheap. I'm going to lower these quite a bit so that I don't worry about the prices really anymore. Full sellout mode. Coaster names for donations. I mean, yes and no. If people donate, I want to give something back. You don't have to donate, obviously, but if you do, I do want to give something back. So that's why I named that coaster after Max Arceus. I think scenery adds a bonus to excitement. Yeah, it does. It's not really worth it in terms of return and the money you get from it, I think. Scenery is only really worth it if you want to absolutely max out your excitement or even need a certain excitement rating. Or if you want to make pretty parks, obviously. Alright, time for the dueling coaster, because I have 100k in the bank. What shall I... Can I actually get the wooden coaster? Hang on, let me check this. Inventions list. Is a wooden coaster on here? It is! I want the wooden coaster. Because I want to make a dueling wooden coaster. Well, that'll have to wait for a bit. Until I unlock it. In the meantime, let's build a... Alright, that's fair, Max Arceus. I'll do that. Which one was it, actually? Alright, it was Lockflume. All those windows. I'll name it after myself. There's always transport rides, yeah. One miniature railway. I'm not a fan of transport rides. Marcel is a Dutch name. No, it's not. Well, it's fairly common in the Netherlands, but it's French, actually, originally. Donald Trump disliked my live stream. Why would he dislike this? I think he'd enjoy it. He doesn't have anything against me, so I think at least. Oh, thank you, Kevin. Did your mum ever tell you why she named you Marcel? Well, mum, if you're still listening, why did you name me Marcel? Because I don't actually know. Did you just think it's a nice name? I don't know if she's still watching, so this might be... She might not hear this. I missed V is the Mole. I have never watched that. We just like the name. That's fair. I like it. So, thank you. So, fun fact about my name, actually. My middle name is Reinier, which was gonna be my first name. But since my last name is Vos, and there's a character in Dutch comics and old Dutch stories called Rein Vos, which was like a sneaky bastard, you know, that kind of thing. They decided to not name me that out of fear of me being bullied for it. So they gave me a new name, Marcel, and gave Reinier as my middle name. I've never used it, but I do like that I have a middle name. What's the name of your first pet? I have never used that security question, so I can tell you. We had two cats called Asterix and Obelix after two comic figures. Comic strip characters. And until I was 7? Yeah. I don't know if we had them. We got them before or after I was born. I don't remember getting them, at least. Let's build a Virginia reel. I like those. Was Obelix fat? I don't know. Probably not. Most cats aren't fat. I've never heard of Glory Hammer, so no. I'm going to Nightwish, though. In November. Excuse me. Twice in a row. On the 23rd and the 24th. Do you speak English at home? I don't really speak at home because I live alone. But otherwise, no. If I speak if I can't speak Dutch from with Dutch people, I will. I don't see a reason to speak English unless I have to. How big of a percentage of your viewers are Dutch? It's quite high. It's about 15%. Which is fairly high, but it's not as high as I might have expected. Considering that a Rollercoaster Tycoon Discord server I'm on, about a third of the people is Dutch. So is your channel done in English just because the viewership is bigger? Yeah, basically. Because, like I just said, only 15% of my viewership is actually Dutch. Which is a lot, considering how few people we have. But it's not a lot in absolute terms. Wait, this is not... What am I doing? Oh... I actually got quite a lot of comments on my videos that went big, like the calculator one, the long roller coaster ones, that I should just make videos in Dutch because of my awful Dutch accent. Oh shit. I can't read the chat at the moment because my laptop has lost connection to the internet. Oh, thank you, Max Arceus. I'm now reading the chat on my computer. So I'm not playing the game at the moment. Let's hope that my my laptop is able to reconnect with my router, because at the moment it is not. Do you live in the region of Holland? I don't. No, I don't. I don't live in North or South Holland. Have you ever made any mods for Roller Coaster Tycoon 2? Well, Open Roller Coaster Tycoon 2 is the only mod I need, so no. Ah, there we go. It's reconnecting back to the internet. Let me reload the stream. There we go. That works again, I think. It's not really working. What about a train around the castle? I'm gonna make a wooden coaster around it, but I first need to unlock it. I will unlock it at some point, because it is one of the rides you unlock. But it might take a while. Alright, what are the stats of this Virginia Reel? I can read the chat now on my laptop again, so that's fine. I just answered that. I do not live in Holland. There is definitely a place, Holland. North and South Holland combined is Holland. Have you thought about playing Park Attack? First off, thank you for the donation. Second off, yes, I've played it a bit, but... Alright, yeah, I'm gonna silent you. I'm gonna give you a timeout, Geitje. Also, I have not seen you donate anything, so... And you're spamming too much. Did you see what I wrote in the super chat? I think so. Let me scroll up. Oh yeah, I didn't actually. First of all, yeah, thank you. Make a crazy colored coaster with an unpredictable layout, dangerous. I name it the Ronald McDonald Trump ride. Sure. Also, I would argue about Holland that there is actually a place called Holland. It's the Netherlands. It's my country. It's called Holland. It might not be the official name, but it's used enough colloquially by a lot of people that it's kind of just another name for it. And I don't mind people saying that they're going to Holland, even though I live in Groningen. I don't mind that at all. It's just, I mean, our travel website is even called holland.com. Ah, fuck. My laptop lost connection to the internet again. What's wrong with my router? My computer is still fine because it's as it is with the LAN cable. Maybe. Hang on. If I just make my cell phone a hotspot, maybe I can connect to that. Ooh, thank you very much, Matt Hill, for the 20 Canadian dollars. Yeah. What kinds of games do you like to play apart from the RCT series? Bloom Star Defense Battles, Factorio. What's the other game? I played Age of Empires today with my brother. That was another game. Gemcraft, I played quite a bit today. Oh, my laptop's back on the internet. I hope it can keep the connection. Oh, and now it's not working again. And I don't want to reset my router, because then the stream's gonna end. So let me see if I can make my mobile into a hotspot. Or just read the chat on mobile. Let me load up the live stream.
Let me load up the live stream.
Oh, I need to. There we go. Sound needs to be off. Sorry about this. Where are the comments? Ooh, the live chat, yeah. Do I have unlimited? No, I don't, but I've just paused the stream and the comments are still coming. So that works fine. It's because I live in Brazil and we call the country Netherlands Hollanda. Yeah, in some languages it's actually just called Holland. So there's no reason to get angry about it. So reading chat is a bit more difficult for me, but I'm going to try to keep up with it. In the meantime, I will build another coaster. Do I have the wooden one unlocked? No, not yet. Alright, inverted coaster. Is there any other way to kill customers instead of drowning them? Yeah. Have them be in a ride that crashes. They will die. How do you make the guests not puke? Have them have a high nausea tolerance. And if they do puke, just clean it up. Have a lot of handymen. Guests will puke. That's, you can't prevent that. Have you ever wanted to go to Cedar Point, Ohio? Yeah, I have. The thing is, it's far away and expensive and all that kind of junk. So, probably not going anytime soon. Place a first aid stall at every big ride. Yeah, you can do that, but I don't really ever have a problem with vomit in my parks. So I don't really pay that much attention to it. Benches help too. Yeah, I do play a lot of benches. So I'm gonna make this one be unpredictable and crazy colored. Just like you asked. That one is the one I want. Are you playing RC Windowed right now? No, I'm reading chat on my mobile phone. Which is why I might be paying a little bit less attention to it sometimes, because it's a bit more difficult to read for me. I'm not paying that much to go to Cedar Point, Ohio. Yeah, pretty much. Ooh, how about this fake out? Make guests think they're gonna go one way, but actually go the other way. Now that's unpredictable. Or how about this unbanked turn? Also very unpredictable. Can you explain what this scenario is about? It's not really about anything specifically, just getting 4,000 guests. I am actually still ahead of schedule. I do need to keep track of that, actually. Alright, let's see. I wanna get back to the station. Now. So, no, that's not what I want. That's what I want. Oh, rip the wall. Oh well, that's fine. Oh, thank you, Bowman. Welcome to the stream. Alright, let's hope the intensity isn't too high on this one. Do you have any pets? I don't. My mom does though. She has a cat called Pookie and he is amazing. I love that guy. Oh, thank you so much, Matt. So after we come together and donate $1,500, we'll be getting a Cedar Point vlog. Probably not. First off, it's more expensive than $1,500 a vacation to America. It also will take at least a week of my time. So I mean, I don't want to go, but it's far away and not only expensive, you know, flying there. I mean, I'm not afraid of flying, but it's not the most fun thing in the world. I have actually thought about starting vlogging and just uploading it on my second channel and see if people would like it. The thing is, what the hell would I vlog about? My life isn't that interesting. I mean, it's a bit of studying, you know, for uni. Sometimes I go play pool or do karaoke with a couple of friends. Can you do the same as you did with the jumping slides video for the Will's water rides? I'm not using cheats in this one, so no. Ooh, gray supports. I like that. Would you prefer a cat or a dog? Definitely a cat. I'm a cat guy. What's the most inversions you've gotten on a coaster? Well, the inversion count maxes out to 31. After that, stops counting. I've gotten a lot more than 31, though. Videos about your thoughts on the real parks and rides might be good. Well, the thing is, I don't really go to theme parks, and there are multiple videos from other people that are way better than anything I could ever say about theme parks. What do you prefer, singing shows or jumping off a cliff? I don't understand that question. One is fun and one is dying. What's... I don't see what the comparison would be. I wanted to check something. Oh, right, the thoughts of my guests, because my park rating is getting lowered. Oh, there's not really a lot of reason for it. I mean, a lot of guests are sick. Maybe I should build first aid stalls. I don't have any of them. On a scale of 1 to 10, what's your favorite color of the alphabet? Platypus! Where's my R key? There's my R key. What's your favorite content creator on YouTube? That's a very good question. And I wouldn't really quickly know the answer. Might be Tom Scott. Tom Scott just makes amazing videos and he's done a couple of great shows as well with friends of his. So, yeah, I'd say Tom Scott. But that might change from time to time, my answer to that question. Don't say Knol Power, please. I don't watch any Dutch YouTubers or Dutch YouTube channels. Mystery Biscuits! Ooh, yeah. Oh, I'm sorry, Studio Massa. I do watch you. Actually, yeah. I forgot about that. Best be careful with your ride overview. I hear Six Flags going to build that half coaster in your parks. I mean, they're welcome to. That's perfectly fine with me. Do I have the wooden coaster yet? I still don't. Damn, there are a lot of coaster types available in this park. What's the highest throughput you've reached for a ride? About 20,000 an hour. Which is a lot, considering the highest throughput in this park at the moment is 4,300. You also watch Dirklink. I actually don't. I'm just... His Mega Park series, I mean, it's a good series. I've watched one video of it. But this is not something I really enjoy watching. And his videos where he explains how to do stuff, I already know 90% of that. So there's no reason for me to watch it. Are you ever going to build a realistic scenery park at some point? Nope. Most likely not. What are your thoughts about frikandelbroodjes? They're absolutely amazing. Also, my laptop has internet again. So, it should now be easier for me to watch the chat and multitask. Oh, never mind, it's gone. Once again. I probably need to restart my router. But I can't restart my router right now. Because then the live stream would end. Are you ever going to do an elbow reveal? Whatever kind of question. Is that related to Davey504's like laugh reveals and Italian voice reveals memes? Slap like. Slap like now. I don't really watch his videos, I watch one every now and then. And I do like bass. Let's build a crooked house. Honestly, right now I'm mostly just waiting until I have... I have the wooden coaster available. I might need to build some micro coaster because I'm noticing I'm falling... I'm not behind schedule yet, but I'm slowing down. So I'm gonna build a couple small coasters. I have some space here. Loads of rides in this park. Yeah, but it also depends on what kind of rides you have. Because you need rides that get a lot of guests. And Flatterites don't really do that. What's the best ride to get a max throughput? Definitely the Twister Coaster. With either boosters, or if you're playing Classic or Vanilla, you need launched lift hills, which are essentially also just boosters. And then you need four stations, and have enough ride, have enough trains that you constantly have trains in stations. Then you get basically four stations simultaneously constantly loading. And they have short trains because the trains are wide for guests, you know, next to each other. So that makes sure that guests don't have to walk a lot on the station, which makes loading quicker. And a couple of people have reached like between 17 and 20,000. That's about the max you can get. Hello, future plays. Standing or sitting trains, I don't think it makes a difference. I usually use floorless trains. Also, I was actually supposed to make this one multicolored. That's what Max Arceus asked for. So I'm gonna do this. And this one all different colors. What color do we not have yet? We do have pink. Well, this kind of blue. Icy blue. And I'm gonna just do this. Couple of random pieces. Now this is crazy colored. The only Zoo Tycoon was the first one. I agree. Second one, well, the second one wasn't bad. Zoo Tycoon 1 and 2 is very much like Roller Coaster Tycoon 2 and 3. Some people prefer Zoo Tycoon 2 or Roller Coaster Tycoon 3, which I can perfectly fine understand, but I don't. I prefer Roller Coaster Tycoon 1 and 2 and Zoo Tycoon 1. More rides. I need more small rides. Let's build four of these. Where can I fit that? I can fit that here. I think you would enjoy Dungeon Keeper. I've heard of that game. It was Nerdcube's seventh most favorite game, seventh best game of all time, in his big top 100 games. I've never played it though. Oh god, these queue lines. There we go. That's another 400 to the soft cast cap. Ooh, glad you enjoyed them, Flavor. Flavor Flow. I also worked out to Nightwish about a week ago. I was with a friend at a little park, like a gym park. In Groningen, and we just put on Planet Hell from Nightwish, and we just went crazy. With, you know, push-ups and all that kind of stuff. Let's build another small coaster. That's actually not that tiny. Not as tiny as the Corkscrew, anyway. Let's build a Corkscrew. Nah, I don't really like it. Ooh, let's build a proper Wild Mouse. What would I do to buff guards and entertainers? Okay, so that's an interesting question. I don't think entertainers need to be buffed. Because in certain situations they can actually be useful. Well, the problem is If you want to... Like, happiness of guests does affect your park rating quite a bit. Quite a whole lot, actually. Problem is, it's very easy to get very happy guests without entertainers. So, if they made it more difficult to raise the happiness of your guests, and so entertainers would be more money efficient for that than they are right now, compared to other things, then entertainers would automatically become better. So that's one thing I would indirectly buff entertainers. And security guards, because they are a lot worse than entertainers, even at the moment. Yeah, what would I do? I don't know. Because there's nothing in my park currently that anything that, you know, the concept security guard would fix. There would be have to be new concepts introduced that a security guard would help prevent, like theft, which is a thing in Planet Coaster. Let them repair vandalism. That's still not useful, because if I do this, highlight path issues, I haven't had one single instance of vandalism in this park. So any security guards would be entirely useless. Oh, thank you, young Dirk. Oh, hey, Ollie. Welcome to the stream. You're a bit of a vandal yourself. Maybe in the Discord server, but not here. Oh, thank you, Evan. Also, someone asked me an interesting question. What made me do YouTube? What made me decide to do YouTube? And actually, I did not want to do YouTube, because I thought I wouldn't be any good at it. And a couple of friends had been telling me that I should do YouTube, make videos about my coasters and all that kind of stuff. But I was terrible at talking to a camera, and I was too nervous about it, so I didn't want to do it. I thought it wouldn't be a lot of fun. But then I uploaded a video of the calculator as a supporting video for my Reddit post about it, because I was posting a lot on Reddit. And that video got picked up by a news site, and it got hundreds of thousands of views. And I got a couple of hundred subscribers from it, like 300 or something in a day. And I thought, well, I've gotten these subscribers. Might as well try to make a channel out of it, because it's now or never. I'm never going to get another golden opportunity like this. I was incredibly lucky with that. So I made a couple of other videos, and they weren't great, but they were interesting enough for people to stick around. And so people stuck around. I kept growing quite fast, actually. And I started, yeah, considering actually doing YouTube. I still wasn't talking in my videos, though, as I was too nervous for that, didn't want to do it. But then I made a slot machine, and I was like, I can't explain this with just text on the screen. It doesn't work. It's too complicated. So I had no options. I had to talk if I wanted to make that video. So I talked in that video. I spoke for the first time. I used a crappy laptop microphone, and it was quite crappy commentary, but it was good enough, and it got a lot of views at the time. And since people enjoyed that, I kept on doing it, and I got nervous at it. I got a lot better at it, better at speaking, and I'm no longer nervous for it anymore. Recording my voice is still by far my least favorite part of making videos. Because I make a lot of mistakes and I have to redo it, and I hear my own mistakes a lot, and I don't like that. But otherwise, I'm not nervous for it anymore doing the live streams. I was incredibly nervous for my first live stream. I did it in April, last April, and I was so nervous for that. But it went very well. People were lovely. And yeah, I do like doing live streams. I can make you nervous if you want. What are you gonna do? Come to my window, stare at me through my window. Do we have the wooden coaster yet? We still don't. Oh, we're gonna unlock it in 7 days. I'm already staring through your window. No, you're not. I am staring through my window. And I only have one. I was already planning that, Matt K. Yeah, I'm gonna do dueling woodies. But first, let me build an army of snowmen. Just because I can. What's the best thrill ride? Either the go-karts or the launched freefall. You did not open the wild mouse ride. Oops. I did not even test it. I didn't even build it. I got distracted. Thank you. The snowmen have awoken. Stats. Well, it's not been tested yet. What are the stats of this one? Oh, actually quite low because it's too short. That's fine though. Do I think I'll make it? Yeah, I'm about 300 guests ahead of schedule. So I'll probably make it. I might need maybe more food stalls or something to keep guests in the park. I don't know really. Do I have enough toilets? I only have 5 toilets. Also, we were talking about music earlier, and although I'm quite a metalhead, I recently really got into Billie Eilish. I really love her stuff. Her latest album, and her only album. Do we have any people in the chat here that like her? Her music? I like it when she says "Done" that song. Yeah, it's amazing. I'm the bad guy. Duh! Then you got a great riff. I love that song. Listen to it a whole bunch of times today. All the good girls go to hell. I like the Poltkai version. Fun fact, there's a comment on the music video for Bad Guy, where Seth Everman says, "I'm the bald guy." And it's the most liked YouTube comment in history, with about 2.2 million likes. Which is amazing. Alright, let's start this dueling coaster. Where's the most space? I think here. I hope I can make this work, because at some point there is not a lot of space. We can also go over the towers. Ooh, thank you, Pain World. Nice name. Love your content. Thank you. Seth got an award for that comment. Yeah, oh, speaking about that. Speaking about the award that Seth got. So you know that video that I uploaded about the longest coaster in December? Under 35 years. In early January, the YouTube creators account, the official account, responded to my tweet about it, saying, DM me. So I DM'd them. And they said, email this and this website saying you're coming from us. So I did. And they asked, that website asked me for my address, for my physical mailing address. So I gave it to them, which is a couple of weeks ago now, and they said they were going to give me a gift. And I haven't gotten anything yet, but I'm really curious. I've heard it can take quite a long time for YouTube to get all that stuff, you know, also like play buttons sent out. Doesn't sound like a scam at all. Well, it does sound like a scam, doesn't it? The thing is, it was the official YouTube creator's account. And the DM conversation I had with the YouTube creator's account was almost identical to the one that Seth Everman, who got the award for the most liked comment, had. Because he showed his in his video about it. Yeah, it was verified. It was all official. And it was almost identical to that. So, I'm not sure what's up with it. And why they would go after me. Because I'm just... it was just a small video, you know? But yeah, I hope that, you know, it's real and everything, and that I do get whatever they're sending me soon. No, the tower. Yeah, there's not enough space. It has to be sacrificed, sadly. This dueling coaster might not have been the best idea. Will you make a special video about it? Definitely. First have to get it, though. Yeah, I don't have the space here for it, so let's just go up. And then more chain lift. So as we can go higher. Also, previously, like a while ago, I said that I can't just build through the walls. And that's because all these wall scenery elements are, you know, they're just one element. I can't make a hole in the wall with, like, still wall below and above it. Because it doesn't work like that. They're very tall wall pieces. You can't only remove the middle part. Alright, let's get some speed on these rides. This is gonna be quite an ugly ride. How to enable day-night life cycle. Go to your options. And go to this tree thing. And then the option is at the bottom. I don't really like it myself. Castle tower is in the way. Well, screw you then. Make sure you don't run out of money. I think it would be quite an achievement for me to run out of money at this point. Let's do an S turn. Right here. Because I can. Can dueling coasters have block sections? They can, but the dueling part isn't gonna take that into account. So if you use block sections on dueling coaster, they will go out of sync. So it doesn't really work. I think they'll be fine though. Also, this isn't perfect. It's a bit off, but it's fine. Those S-turns, yeah, they won't kill the guests. Guests are sturdy enough. Oh, my phone just went black. There we go. The way Marcel says throughput is so satisfying. For some reason, it's probably my accent or something. A lot of people are either don't know the word or are mishearing me and think that I say like through boot, like the boot you put on your feet or the boot of your car. So I get questions like what's through boot? It's just really funny actually. I have that with the word vodka. I don't know. I still don't know how it's pronounced in English. Vodka or vodka. In Dutch it's vodka. What's better, looping a corkscrew? Well, purely based on utility, the corkscrew is better because of the micro corkscrew coaster. But if you're more looking at generally how good the coaster is, you know, when you build actual coasters, then the looping coaster is quite a bit better. I don't know how well these coasters will be dueling. Might not be at all. Worcestershire or Worcestershire. I know it's not Worcester. Does having a popular YouTube channel get the ladies? Well, about 3% of my audience is female. So probably not. Ooh, let's do a turn like this. Bet they'll not expect that. Although I did this quite a while ago, it was on the 11th of November. I remember that because it was Sint Maarten in the Netherlands, which is which is sort of a holiday. I did see one female fan of me. Well, not exactly a fan, but someone who watches my videos occasionally. And her boyfriend, who was a fan. That was usually fine, because it's not going that fast there. How's your mom doing? Speaking about female fans, she's one. But if we're talking about getting the ladies, my mom doesn't count. For obvious reasons. Can you make support to cover up the wall invisible? I probably can, but it's a lot of work. And also requires cheats. But yeah, if we're talking about getting the ladies, I don't think making videos about Roller Coaster Tycoon 2 falls in that category. It's quite nerdy. And not exactly for getting the ladies. I mean, not that I care about that. It's not what I'm trying to achieve with this, obviously, but no. There are nerdy lanes out there, yeah. Oh, ready to play for you. I've already ranted about that earlier in the stream. You've missed it. I think it's a piece of shit. And Atari is abusing the Roller Coaster Tycoon name. These kind of weird diagonal sections are interesting to build. I don't really like them usually. Good night, Erbsen. Imagine me actually... Oh wait, Erbsen wasn't going. Good night, Timothy. Imagine actually walking into a bar, walking up to a random girl and saying, hey baby, want to talk about Roller Coaster Tycoon intensity ratings. Imagine actually doing that. Where's the station? I'm quite close by. Damn, that's a long coaster. I cannot understand German. Well, I mean, if it's slowly spoken a bit, I can read German somewhat. Not because I can actually read German, but because it's close enough to Dutch and English that I can, you know, understand some of it that way. But no, I don't actually speak German or any other language besides English and Dutch. I've had 6 years of French in high school. Don't speak a word. Why do you speak some words? And I can read it a bit. But I don't actually speak French. Where did you pick up English? The internet, basically. I mean, you see, in the Netherlands, we have English classes. I started in year 7 on primary school. I was 9 at the time. And you continue in high school for 6 years. But that's not where most people actually learn most of their English. Because we do not dub anything except kids who are really young kids. We always dub, so you learn English that way. No, we always do subtitles. So you learn English that way. And the internet is in English. There's of course also Dutch websites for a lot of things, but the big stuff is in English. And people watch YouTubers, you know, that all that kind of stuff. That's how I learned English. Or most of my English at least. Add some inversions. Not on a Woody. It can do inversions, but I'm not going to add them. Thank God for dubbing. Why? I don't like dubbing. I mean, for small kids, obviously, yeah, but once you're like, I don't know, 11, 12, subbing is better because the original English voices are almost always better. And the mouth movements actually match up. So no, I dislike dubbing. For anything else than young kids. I do remember going to the movies with our babysitter when we were like, I don't know, like 7 years old or something. And she said that if she wasn't with us, she would have gone through the English, to the English version with subtitles. But because we were there, we went to the Dutch version. Is there any other English than American? Please. British English. I always have all my stuff, my computer and whatever, in British English, not American English. Let's actually speed up the chain lift a bit. And there's also Australian English. And New Zealandish English. Canadian English, yeah, as well. Alright, let's see how well they actually duel. Well, it's more racing. I think blue one will pull ahead quite a bit because we're doing a circle to the left and blue is on the inside. So yeah, blue will win. That's fine. Someone said I needed longer stations, which is fair. Oops. I wonder how high the stats will be. Probably around 7.5 excitement, maybe a little bit less. Probably around 8.5 intensity. Yeah, I could have the blue coaster. You know, I could just... Actually... I could do this. Let me close it. I'm gonna do a helix. Wait, it needs to go the other way around. Because if we have a helix with blue on the outside and brown on the inside, then blue will have longer to travel. And damn it. Let's see if this works, if this fits. Perfect. I could also add some brakes, yeah, but this is more fun. Oh, wait. I need to test them both simultaneously. There we go. Is it possible to make them switch tracks so they're going to the other stations? Yeah, if you make both coasters the same coaster, both tracks, you can make a Mobius coaster, that's what it's called. That works as well. Then you have like station 1, station 2. This took a long time to build. Alright. Oh, thank you. Once again, Pain World. You're not bringing me pain. Are you into roller coasters in real life? What are your favorites? Which coaster are you looking forward to checking out? I do have a favorite, Goliath in Wallaby World. I'm not really a coaster enthusiast. I do like riding them. And I'm not... I mean, I would like to go to some of the big parks in America once. But like I said before, that's, you know, expensive, big holiday. So probably not going to happen anytime soon. But I would like that. So yeah, like King Dakar, you know, all those extreme rides. And there we go. We can now open them. Have you considered starting a Patreon? I have one. It's linked in the description of this video, of this live stream. I have not been to Bollywood. I have never been outside of Europe. Well, Canary Islands are technically African, but it's still Spanish. Right, what are the stats? Let's wait for that. Oh, fuck. Excessive lateral Gs on both of them. Where? Let's follow the trains. The helixes? I didn't think they were going that fast there still. But apparently I was wrong. I thought they were going to be like 50 kilometers an hour, which would have been fine. But I was wrong. Alright, let me do some brakes. Now the S band after the steep descent is fine. It's not going that fast there. At least I think so. All Alright, this will probably be fine. Do you speak Dutch with an accent? No, I speak like pretty much exactly standard Dutch. I do recently slip in more English words. Because a lot of the time I read English and type English, so I'm starting to think in English. But I don't speak with an accent or a dialect or anything. Also, I need to color these. What does your R sound in Dutch? Rond. Ronde draaiende draaimolens. That's my R. Let's make ice and fire. Or if you speak English with a Dutch accent. I mean, you're hearing my English right now. I don't think I have too much of a Dutch accent, but it's definitely there. Wait. What? Ah, fuck. It didn't make the next hill. Did anyone die? No. That's good. Oh, there we go again. More trains. I can just lower this hill. This should work. And if not, it will crash again, and we will know once it crashes, because I'm not going to pay attention to it. No, it's not the first crash on the live stream. We had a couple of crashes before. And I don't mind these crashes. Why do you live in Brazil? I don't. Alright, I'm gonna open this right. Let's hope that we don't get another crash. No, people didn't die in the crash. So that's fine. Oh, whoops, people did die. People are still going on it though. So that's fine. Nah, just two people. It'll be gone soon enough. People will forget about it. I need more mechanics. You know what? I'm just gonna hire a whole bunch of staff because I have a shit ton of money. Also, my park rating is going down. Close all the windows, yes please. The PR department of Marshall Land has concluded nobody died. Wait, people did die. Ah, just two people. More than 100 handymen. Actually, no. Exactly 100. I think. Yeah, exactly 100. Did I just get an award? Yeah. Most beautiful park in the country. So beautiful, those dead bodies of those guests. Place two gravestones in their memory. Do we have the gravestone available? I do. There we go. Two gravestones. In their memory. Alright, here are the trains. Let's see if they make it now. They do. Not very fast though, but they do make it. Oh, it's already gone around. It's still too extreme. Shit. But people are riding it. It's fine. People are still riding it. So I'm going to keep this. It's got 18 drops, which is quite a lot. They're more than a mile long. Nah, ride isn't tainted forever. It's going to be tainted for a bit, but not forever. Alright, it's April and we are almost at 3,700 guests. And we have about 80% still to go of the year. So we're gonna make it. Am I doing tutorials in difficult scenarios again? Perhaps. Let's make a river rapids. We don't have much space left. I can make it here. I think, yeah. That should work. I've never seen an underwater coaster. Because it doesn't exist. I mean, you can build underwater, but then you have this underground under the lake bed, you know? You can't actually build inside water. You need to drown 10 more people. I like to keep my rating high. I want to pass the scenario. So, no. This is quite a boring ride. it's short and it's got a lot of things right next to each other. If you disable clearance checks, can things be built underwater? Yeah, then you can build inside water. Although, if you disable the clearance checks, you cannot build boat hires on land. Even with disabled clearance checks. I did do that in my cursed rights video. But I did use some other tricks for that. Because just disabled clearance checks is not enough. Actually, I want a lower minimum waiting time. Right, let's see if any coasters are too expensive. Or other rides. There are. I left the stream, walked to the record store to look for Nightwish, came back and you're still streaming. Did you find it? Did you find Nightwish? Also, welcome back. What the frick is Nightwish? It's some heavy metal band, symphonic metal. It's my favorite band. And no, it was used records, so the selection can be limited. I mean, you can't just listen to the album on YouTube or Spotify. So, that works. Or you can probably buy it online, buy it digitally. Seeing thrown to you by Skillshare. You want to learn how to sacrifice people to the Lords of the Wood. Lord of Wood. With over 1200 videos about staging accident sacrifices, Skillshare has you covered. I have not gotten an offer from Skillshare yet. I have gotten one offer from another company that you see a lot on YouTube videos lately. That's sponsoring a lot of YouTubers. But I'm not going to take it. And I'm not going to say which one it was. That's also one of probably the only one or two legit sponsorship emails I've gotten. I've gotten so many spam emails. It's like contact.maria@gmail.com or something like that. And then like, hello, your YouTube channel has very good numbers. We would like to work with you. We can pay you $500 for an advertisement of 1 minute. Please email back with your answer. Or something like that in half broken English. Nothing saying about the actual thing they want me to advertise, because it's a scam. Ooh, the inverted impulse coaster. I like that actually. Where can I build it though? I think this will fit. I also got an email quite a while ago now that said there was a problem with your account, so we locked your account or something like that, or we need your info to make sure that, you know, stuff is safe. And they just asked me for my password and my YouTube channel name, as if YouTube wouldn't know my YouTube channel name. You have a signed copy of Rollercoaster Tycoon 2? Damn, that's cool. I mean, I've lost my copy a long time ago. I have it digitally now, but that's cool. Wait, this is not connected to the entrance. What countries have you visited? The Netherlands, Germany, Belgium, Luxembourg, Austria, Czech Republic, Slovenia, Croatia, Bosnia-Herzegovina, Greece, Italy, San Marino, Vatican City, Monaco, France, Andorra, Spain, Switzerland, the United Kingdom, and Iceland. And which would I like to visit? I want to go to Iceland again, but this time in the summer. Sorry, in the winter. I went in the summer, but I want to go there in the winter. And which do I want to visit that I haven't been yet? I mean, a lot of countries are beautiful, but I don't really have like a bucket list country that I want to go to. Yeah, Norway probably. Oh, I've been to Denmark. Actually, I forgot Denmark. That was in 2005. I've been to Legoland as well. Why did I not take the sponsorship? Well, it wouldn't fit my channel. And it would feel like selling out. So even though they will probably offer a good amount of money, because a lot of people are doing it, if it doesn't fit my channel, then I'm not gonna do it. Like, if, say, a new Roller Coaster Tycoon game or theme park game came to me and it was actually good, even though I maybe wouldn't play it a lot, I would probably still take the sponsorship and make a video about it, because it's a Roller Coaster Tycoon game, it fits my channel. Who cares about selling out? Make that money. I care about selling out. Because it just doesn't feel right. So, yeah. Ooh, we need just 50 more guests. We're getting there. Isn't Monaco in Africa? No, it's Morocco. Monaco is a microstate bordering France and the Mediterranean Sea, quite near to Italy. Monaco is actually the country with the highest population density in the world, with about 16,000 people per square kilometer. Which is just because it's only a city. It's not really fair to compare to an actual country. Does my education in AI require calculus? It does. I have passed 4 calculus courses. 3 for astronomy, a couple of years back, and 1 for, well, 2 actually, now 2 for AI, which were actually the same as the calculus for astronomy, just a lot less content. So, basically, calculus 1, 2, and 3. If the park's already free to enter, no, then I think it won't do anything. Unless you also have no rides? I'm not sure. Like, if the ride price is of your park is low enough compared to what you could charge, then it won't do anything, or do less, at least. Why did I retake it? Because it was quite a while ago, and I wanted to make sure that I was still able to do it. If I did not pause it, I could just use the grades from the previous calculus courses. Although they are technically slightly different. They're different names. So I'm not sure exactly how that would have worked. How do you solve overcrowding? More path. Like, imagine my park's overcrowded. And I'll just build a path here. Make it go to the other side. This is not a great path because it's ugly. You kind of want to have like smaller loops generally. This works fine. I'm asking because I really want to know what you'd focus on if you wanted to make your own theme park game. To be honest, I would, if I made my own theme park game, I would just take Roller Coaster Tycoon 2, remaster it with HD graphics, but keep the same style. Add a whole load of options that Open Roller Coaster Tycoon has. And another whole ones that I would personally want. Basically, yeah, Roller Coaster Tycoon 2, but remaster them better. No, there's no limit on the number of guests that can occupy a single path. Hey, I passed the goal. A little bit over half a year before before the deadline. Ooh, with a company value of over 1 million, and but about a third of that is just cash. Make a lot of money. Marcel. And I'll take a screenshot of it. Giant screenshot. Now we have a lot of money. Let's have some fun. Let's do this. Actually, let's make it red. Now this is a ground texture. Okay, so let's save it before we properly mess it up. Oh, thank you, Pain World. Damn, you keep donating. Thank you. Thought on Planet Coaster. It's a great game. It's not for me. Whee! I like doing this. It's more fun if the park is less densely populated, though. Is that hell? I mean, sort of. Oh, I'm almost through my money. I spent 350k on landscaping. Why is it not for you? Jeez, man. I mean, thank you, but, you know, it's a lot of money. So why is it not for me? Well, Planet Coaster is more about building pretty parks, beautiful scenery, you know, all that kind of stuff. And more attention to detail. And that's not really... I just want to casually build a park, you know, like this scenario. And that Planet Coaster is not for that. So... about the most difficult scenario I've ever played. I'm not going to play it right now, but I will show it. It's called Quantum... where is it? Maybe it's under Expert Parks. Would make sense. I can't find it. Oh, here, yeah. Quantum's Edge. So, the goal of this scenario is to have 3,400 guests in your park, and you may not let the rating drop below 700 at any time. That basically means if it drops below 700, you have a month to get it back up again, or otherwise you will lose because your park will be closed. And you get one extra month at the start. Only in April that mechanic kicks in. So, you have a couple of scenario options. No marketing. No landscape changes. Park rating is harder and to increase and maintain, which is basically it's 100 lower than it would normally be. And guests are more difficult to attract. That means that apart from the first 1,000 guests, you need to build coasters, see ya, Justin, longer than 600 meters on this bit of ground. You cannot access these middle islands. So, and you can only purchase the raised land. And it's 90 apiece. Which is really expensive. And it's actually very difficult to raise your park rating enough in time before the end of April and your park gets closed. But I have completed it. And let's load it up. Alright, I don't know which one it is. Okay, it's not this save file. I think it was number 3. Yeah. So, this is my completed park. The rides have these colors for the... for the Most Dazzling Colors Award. Just check this. All these kind of crazy corkscrew coasters. With helixes. Yeah, this, I put it in videos. With helixes so that they are actually long enough. And even though all these motion simulators are not contributing to the guest cap, they are still very necessary. Because their queue lines soak up guests so that I don't get overcrowding issues. So that was another thing. I had to deal with overcrowding and with making long enough coasters. You also have a couple of short coasters to get that initial 1,000. The 5th of June, year 8. I passed the goal. How's the park rating calculated? It's actually quite complicated. Dirklink has a video on it. It's like 9 different factors. But yeah, Dirklink has a video. And I've written a video about it as well. I haven't made it yet. But guest happiness is an issue. Like goes into it. The number of rides that have recently crashed. Or people that have died in ride crashes. And a whole lot more that I can't remember right now. Do you think you are the best in the world at Roller Coaster Tycoon 2? It's possible. I can never be sure because there might be people better that are just, you know, playing on their own. But at certain aspects, I might be the best in the world. At other aspects, I'm definitely not. But yeah. Like, knowing, like, you know, ride stats and all that kind of stuff and ride stat requirements. All that kind of stuff, I might be the best at in the world. It's possible. Only because I spent so many hours on it. Yeah, that's my knowledge of the mechanics is extremely in-depth. There are a lot of people, like Dirklink knows a lot about it as well. But that's more like in the hacking department, how that works. So slightly different, that's what he might know the most about. Although there are a couple of other people without YouTube channels that know a lot about it as well. And I don't know all the basic mechanics. There are quite some that I don't really know. But there are so many, so that's not unexpected. Good night, Bailey. Yeah, the radioactive sea is contributing quite a lot to painful eyes. Just look at this coaster. It's all the way from here across this entire slither of land. How many attempts did you need? Well, I did not start over once, but I did need to load a previous save twice because I failed. So you could name it 3 attempts, but not 3 entire attempts. But twice I did need a backup. Who makes the most efficient park? Well, the most efficient park is, you can also have multiple definitions, like what's the most money efficient park, most guests, but the best looking. It's not, you can't define that. Was money an issue? Well, when I was still buying land, it was definitely an issue. Later though, like I have 42k in the bank, wasn't really an issue because building these coasters is quite a slow process. Because you don't have a lot of land to work with, and you have to make them all from scratch, because they need to be long. So I didn't build fast enough for money to be an issue. How many hours a week do you say you play RST? Not a lot anymore. I actually barely play on my own anymore. Sometimes I compete in one of the contests for Rollercoaster Tycoon and Rollercoaster and Friends, a Discord server. I might play a park every now and then. Or experiment with, well, I'm working on a big project. Which I've put quite a bit of time in. But I mostly play other games, actually. If you were able to meet Chris Sawyer someday, what would you ask? I don't know if I would ask anything. I would just thank him, you know, for creating this game. And what would I ask him? Yeah. I don't know what he thinks about the community and my channel and other things that people have created. And I would also ask him if he's a tits man or an ass man. Ha ha ha. It's strange what has become of Chris Sawyer's career. Yeah, he did work on Classic, Roller Coaster Tycoon Classic, a couple of years ago. So he's not entirely out of, you know, the Roller Coaster Tycoon brand business thing. But yeah, you see, I also heard that he doesn't really like sandbox games, which is also why Roller Coaster Tycoon 2 didn't have a full sandbox mode. So I'm not sure what he thinks about me just, you know, building calculators and stuff, which is obviously sandboxing. You should make Suit Tycoon videos. No, Suit Tycoon is only good for Let's Plays. You can't really optimize there. Or maybe for meme videos, but not for my kinds of videos. How could you create an extremely fast and twisty coaster without compromising the excitement to intensity ratio? You can't. Not really. I mean, if it's going to be fast and twisty, you're going to have high lateral Gs, high vertical Gs, so you're going to have high intensity rating. April Fool's Suit Tycoon video. Now, I have another video for April Fool's, which I wanted to make last year, but last year I had kind of a motivation problem around that time of year, so it didn't really happen. Is there a way to get the scenarios from RCT1? Yes. You can either download recreations, which you can find online just by Roller Coaster Tycoon 1 scenario recreations. Google that, you'll find it. Something like that. Or you can buy Roller Coaster Tycoon 1, go to your options, then to the gear wrench thing, and then pass to RCT1 installation. Do that, and then you get all the scenarios right here. With the best one being Diamond Heights. Ah, that's better on the ice. I mean, you weren't going to fall for my video anyway, because it wasn't trying to fool you. It was just, you know, a stupid, exaggerated, you know, video, kind of like that. Are you a Coke guy or a Pepsi guy? If I have to choose Coke, but I don't drink it anyway. Stu got me with his last year. What was his April Fool's video? I don't recall. Let me go to his channel. I've probably watched it. Let's see, almost a year ago. I don't see any videos that would be April Fool's around 10 months ago. Are you sure it wasn't the year before that? Because I do remember him making an April Fool's video. I don't know. I can't find it. Also, I see that I've gotten 3 new Patreons during this stream. Thank you guys so much. For this. It's not very late. I mean, it's 23 minutes past 11. That's not that late. Strange question, as you're Dutch. Do you say you use English more than Dutch in your day-to-day life? It depends on the day. Like, talking to people in real life, Dutch, obviously. But on a day like today, like, I've spoken Dutch to my brother for a while, because we called Well, other than that, my internet usage was English today, and this stream is English, so... Yeah, today it's English. And if I'm working with non-Dutch people at uni, it's also probably English. Favorite coaster type to build with? Definitely the Twister coaster. It has a lot of options, you can do a lot of stuff with it. And it's just, it's also great, great stats with the floorless trains. I just like it. Do you still get the spinning cars for the Steel Mini Coaster? Yes, I think you do. Or those are like custom trains? Let me see. No, not that. No. I need the object selection. Junior coasters. Wait, it's called a Steel Mini Coaster. I think. Or not. Or is it called Junior Coaster? Oh, yeah, here. Oh, I can't find the... Or is it called a Mini Coaster? No, it's the Mini Roller Coaster. I have seen those trains, though. They definitely do exist. I might not have them. Oh, these seem to be sort of spinning rides. It says for the Virginia Reel, but the images of the Junior. I like using the hardline coaster. I find three dimensions confusing. Well, I find the hardline more confusing for not being in three dimensions. If you're gonna kick any dimension, I would say it's height. Wait, so what does two exactly do? I still don't know what Stu did. I want to know now. I have a friend who doesn't use Dutch unless it's to his parent. It's to his parents. He isn't very social outside the house. Yeah, I do use Dutch whenever I talk to anyone who's Dutch. Best coaster, Floorless, definitely. Same reason, it can do a lot. You can easily get high stats, can be small, can be big. Let's spice these coasters up a bit. Let's unlock operating limits. Close them. And power launch. That should be fun. I'm just messing about now. I'm gonna make guests go on it. I'm gonna make them ignore intensities. Does the go-kart teleport trick work with the hard line? No, it doesn't. Because it only works with vehicles that are guest-controlled, which are the go-karts, which is the mini-golf, and perhaps a few others that I'm missing, but not any roller coaster cars. Which is a shame, because I want vertical teleportation that actually works for roller coaster cars, not only go-karts. But sadly, that might be impossible. I was wondering if you recommend the Groningen University. I mean, I don't know how any other Dutch universities are. But I think Groningen is great. So, I would recommend it. Not necessarily over the other ones, because I don't know how they are. I've never checked out any others. But there are a lot of international students here, and Groningen is a real student city. So, yeah, it should be great. I'm guessing you're German from your username. Make a meme coaster park. I might at some point. Thoughts on the scenario where every vehicle is the swan's boat? That wouldn't really work. Coasters wouldn't work, and I'll show you why. Object selection, I need the swans. And you're right. Well, I have two German girls in my mentor group on uni, and they seem to be doing great, both. So, from that sample size of two, I can extrapolate that Germans will do very great at the University of Groningen. I already have the swans boats. Let's see. Show vehicles from other track types. Let's do the swans. Why is it not showing up? Oh, because I haven't invented it yet. Probably. What percentage of your subscribers is Dutch? About 15%. Inventions list, move all items to top. Still not there. Oh well, rowing boats are basically the same and it just doesn't work. I once was attacked by a swan. What do you recommend? I don't recommend any Dutch unis because I don't know anything about them. Except Groningen. So I can't say anything. Yeah, you see, the problem about with this boat is that it's just not going very fast. And the swan's boat would be exactly the same. And going uphill is very slow and it might actually stall. Or might not. It won't, but yeah, swan's boats are not a normal boat. Are not great. So I think I'm going to cut it here and stop the stream. It was a fun one. I liked it. So thank you guys all very much for watching and asking the interesting questions. I liked answering them. So yeah, thank you all for watching, tuning into the stream, participating, and everything, you know. And I'll see you next time. Good night.